I've been using Prima for about 6 months now. Yeah, it's cool.
I'm Liam.
And I'm Carlo.
We're doing a documentary on the Whitefriars epidemic of fruit juice known as Prima.
These juice addicts running around amok in their own school.
So we've decided to conduct interviews with the dealers themselves.
And go in the inside life of what really is a junkie.
Christ. These are real events, real people, real stories.
Few people would believe that an innocent children's fruit juice such as Prima could be used as a powerful narcotic at high doses. Students at Whitefriars College have recently been exploiting the effects of high Prima dosage despite the damaging effects. Meet Jeremy, a sad story of Prima addiction gone wrong. He is the main example of a serious Prima addict that some people would refer to as a juice junkie. You always find people like him around the canteen scavenging for loose change that gets lost underneath the decking. Despite his lack of soberness, we have documented his daily life routine as a juice junkie.
You sometimes go looking to the bin for anything you can get. Feel good.
How do you usually get money so you can afford juice in the first place?
Look, I usually just get money at the canteen.
Sure.
Yeah.
Let's go over there now, see what we can find.
What is this?
Found an empty juice carton. What are you doing there?
I want the Prima!
This is disgusting.
He really needs his Prima.
What type of sick addiction is this?
What are you gonna do? Can't get your little Prima?
What are you gonna do with that, you juice?
How long has it been?
Jeremy always carries a toy gun around just so he can feel safe from the paranoia caused by his juice addiction.
Seems that...
He's got a little cap gun. Where'd you find your cap gun from?
I'll kill you.
He must be an addict as well.
We later find Jeremy up near the top car park, still playing with his little cap gun, which he thinks is real.
We're going in to meet Jeremy, one of the Prima addicts now. See what all this fuss about this gun is about. Hey, Jeremy. What's with the gun? Like, why do you carry that around?
Texting, you know.
From
you never
who?
Know who's after you, man.
Who are you scared of?
people in my head, man. They're telling me people come get me.
The voices in your head?
Yeah.
What do the voices say?
Oh, like, people's gonna come get me, eh?
So, right, show us your protection. What are you gonna, what?
Mate, fucking, 9mm, bro, 9mm.
Where'd you get that from?
These motherfuckers, they'll hit you, these babies, they'll hit you 2,000 feet per second, bro.
So, you do realise that's just a cap gun, bro?
Mate, it's a real gun, you stupid. Hey, you stupid, don't tell me, mate. It's real, bro, it's protection.
I'm done with this interview, let's just go. He's way too high. Yeah, he's way too high.
Due to the constant strain of Prima usage throughout Whitefriars College, it has caused a rapid decline in academic capabilities of this college. As you can see here, one particular student, once an A grade achiever, he is now failing VCAL. Signs of Prima usage is evident, as you can see, use cartons, use drink containers, unresponsive behaviour. It can see that this person is very much under the influence of Prima. As we are about to discover for ourselves, we will investigate further into the individual's cases of their own private struggles.
Okay. So, I'll be conducting an interview about, you know, what Prima was like for you. So, we'll start off just by telling everyone a little bit about yourself, yeah?
Hi, my name's Steve. I've been sober for about 2 months now.
Yeah, and, when was the first time you actually decided to try Prima?
Well, I first tried it at a party. A couple of mates were there that were doing it, so I thought, give it a go, see how I go.
Sure. And was that alright for you? Like, how'd it feel?
It's pretty good. Got real juiced up. Got a good high off it. Really enjoyed it.
So when you finally did decide to quit, like, how was it? Was it tough? Or tell me a bit about it.
It was really tough. First time, I tried it a couple of times. Didn't get it. Just the craving. The seduction of the juice box was just too strong and got me. But then I decided to try again, went cold turkey. My girlfriend said she'd dump me if I didn't. So I knew it was really a problem, so I did go for it. But I still crave that sweet fat juice box flavour every damn day.
After the interview was finished and we had packed up, I decided to put him through a final test.
Cool. Oh, one more thing before you leave. I have something for you. What do you think of this?
No, don't tempt me with that. No, put it away.
Well, this is your chance to prove yourself. You say you're over Prima. No,
put it away. I'm leaving.
Shifty juice dealers can always be found strolling around the school grounds. We are currently working on finding out more people with connection to juice, as well as maybe getting an interview with the dealer themselves.
What? The juice?
The juice that has taken over our school. What do you think about it?
Everyone's addicted to Prima juice boxes.
Seems like you're a bit of an addict as well.
Yeah, but I don't know anything about the Prima juice boxes. It's all about the Coca-Cola, ladies and gentlemen.
Ah, she's into a Coke.
Okay, we've organised a special interview with one of the dealers themselves who actually supplies a lot of the clients of his at Whitefriars itself. He's organised to meet us, but he wants to remain confidential and have his identity hidden. So we're going to go in, conduct a quick interview, and then we'll see if we can get anything out of it. I'm really nervous, actually. This should be the spot. He asked to meet him here. Why is it locked? Let's try the other bathroom. Anyone in here? After coming into contact with the dealer, we decided to just do what he says and follow him, even though we had no idea where he would take us.
First thing, tell me a little bit about this drink. Like, what's it actually like?
First off, it's Prima's like an experience like no other. It's crazy. I'm speechless trying to describe how it actually feels to be on Prima. Just imagine being on a roller coaster, having an orgasm, like, just times that by like 10.
That's Prima.
That's Prima.
So, what's your opinion on like the addictive side of Prima?
The only way I can explain it is just like getting a brand new video game, really. Just get up in the morning, you just want to play. You just want to play, get home from school, you just want to play. It's really just like Prima. Get home from school, you want some Prima. Wake up in the morning, you want some Prima. So lunchtime, you want some Prima.
So it's like getting like your GTA 5 fix?
Yeah, exactly. Basically. Just exactly like that. So if I don't really know the customer or it's a, you know, someone like a year 7, I tend to use my little tactics, my reduce tax. Come, I'll show you.
Where's this one?
Hey, Liam, where are we going?
I don't know, man.
Do you trust this guy? Scared me.
Using a bit of water.
Getting close.
Tending to take some juice for myself. Keeping the juice for myself. Get myself high. Just use, you know, a little bit of water. These are for the year 7s and the people I don't know.
God.
After the interview, we soon left. We occasionally see this guy at school, but it's rare occasions that he's even at school in the first place. And now that was out of the way, there was only one thing left to do.
Hey.
Hey, what's up?
Did you bring the stuff?
You want this?
Sure, here's the money.
Prospect, what are you doing?
I'm putting my lock. Deposit charges.
I've lost my partner. I don't even know what's going on anymore. What's this? No. No! Liam! No! Liam!